Jutsu's game here. For some reason, this starts off way late. Okay. Okay, first time doing this, I just want to see what the fuck this is. Alright, so timeline is backspace, pause play is P, speed up and down is plus minus, normal speed is zero, got it. Okay. Scoreboard is tab. H is hide everything. Team fight is a okay. Okay. All right, so we got Teemo in the blue side playing top lane. Teemo no Jutsu. I'm gonna go manual. I'm actually gonna direct camera on him. So they've got Vi in the jungle, Azir mid, Ash bot with Thresh. Okay, not horrible. I'm actually just gonna go to Teemo. And they've got Lux mid lane, Nasus is top. Is this the right game? He said he got his shit pushed in by Trendemir. So it looks like this is a Nasus game. I thought it was Trendemir, but I guess it's Nasus. Lux in the mid, Lee jungle with MF Annie. Ooh, this is just a fucking annoying comp. But I typically don't really fan that position there. Especially in lower elo, I'm going to be in this brush here, standing in stealth with Green Father's Gift. I don't know if you have that mastery, but I highly suggest it. It's 3% of the guy's health for free, basically, on top of what you get with your auto and burn. So, again, you're already kind of making a mistake here. You're playing all the way back in around your caster minion's line, allowing him, like, if you wanted to punish the fact that he's going to take this CS here, you're already too far back, right? So what you need to be doing is in this brush and in this brush here and zoning him off, right? So, like, if you were here or you were here, he could not be standing where he is because he's going to take damage with no retaliation, right? We click on him and he's taken, let's just hit tab, how about that? He's taken Corrupting Pot and so have you. It's fine, it's a fine start, but I prefer D-Ring, so you, especially against Nasus, so you can spam Q. Corrupting Pot's fine too. You just gotta understand you're gonna not have as much mana against him, and you're gonna have to pick and choose your Qs. So, again, in this situation, you can still be farming these minions while standing in this brush and poking his ass if he stands this close to wave and then de-aggro back into the brush, right? And if he tries to all in you, you can kite back into the second brush, and you're gonna win that every time. You just got to be careful. Like, if you all get all in right here, you actually might lose the all in just because you don't have blind and he's got three minions and you've got one. So just make sure you kite back here so you can get the help from your five minions, and he only gets help from, he'll probably get all five, all four, because you've got your ahead in minions. So you should win that trade if you kite back properly. But that's just if he loses his mind, and it doesn't look like he will because he's so far back. So again, My suggestion would be to you be playing in these brushes, especially if you've got Greenfather's Gift, to just keep getting spamming the shit out of that. Otherwise, I like to play right here between the wall and his caster minions because it kind of forces him to be back here. And if your minions are dying back here and he's over here, he's not getting any XP. That's what we want. We don't want him getting any XP. You know, forget about the gold from last hitting. We want him to be level 1 for as long as humanly possible. If we can get to level 3 before he gets to level 1, that's like the ultimate goal. It's really hard to do, though. So, he steps forward. You poke him. That's good. Okay, you get 2 pokes off. Okay, so here's... let's play that back. Okay. So, what's going to happen here is... He's going to step forward, and you're going to poke, but you're just going to stand, you're just standing there. You're not moving your champ around. Like, if you walk in a circle, it does nothing. So what's happening is you're attacking him while these three are now all aggroing you. You just took a fair bit of damage there, probably 10% of your health just to minion damage. And they're still going after you. So all you have to do is pop into that brush and pop out, and you would still be roughly full health. But instead, you guys are somewhat even in health, even after all the shit you just pulled on his ass. So I would suggest you always de-aggro in the brush. Don't forget that that's the case. I forgot you took Smite as well. Smite's fine. You just have to understand, okay, so in this case, I don't know if, maybe I would have taken D-Ring anyway, but to start, but Corrupting Pot's probably good too. You gotta understand that I was wondering why you did no damage with your autos. Yeah, taking that, you gotta be careful, obviously. Keep spamming, that's good. Okay, you got one more. Okay, so... Vi gets executed in the jungle. That's hilarious. So that's good. See, the problem is your autos do literally no damage to the guy. So your goal here is to farm and to poke as much as possible. So now you've got Corrupting Pot advantage here. So it looks like you have less health, but in fact you have more effective health than he does. So just keep letting him spam. And you want to keep shoving this into tower. Right now you're not hitting the minions. You need to shove this hard into tower because he can wave clear a lot faster than you. So keep poking his ass right now under tower. You should be poking and poking and poking. Like right now. Like, yeah. So now you want to let this just crash in the middle. And then zone him back off again, right? So he can't all in you. Where are you going? No, you don't watch mid ever. That is nothing. There's nothing you can do about it. You don't have teleport. Now you're just getting poked out, and you just let him sustain back up to full health with his Q. So now what we're going to do is we're just going to freeze the lane right here and call for help. Like right there, you should not have killed that minion. Let's go back. Okay. So in this scenario, we're letting him push. We're not going to kill this creep. We're going to let it live because that one's low. Like we talked about before, it takes 4 creeps to create a freeze. You've only got 2.25 creeps. So that third creep would have slowed the push even harder, even with him pulling this shit on you every 2 seconds. Again, like, I don't know if I would go Smite build against Nasus, just because, actually, maybe I would. I think Smite build's actually okay. You just gotta focus on farming, because what you need to get to is Bloodraiser, and then you need to get to, actually, I would have started jungle item. I would not have started this. Excuse me. When you start Smite, you want to start jungle item, and then you want to take the Gromp as the game begins, or try and go steal one of his golems, or 2 of his golems. But I think Smite works better that way than just going straight into lane with it. You need to take something for your time with that. And when you get, see now you're going MR and he's not even building any AP yet. So this is gimping our build path quite heavily. Like, you don't need to do this. You need to start making your, so right now you are fully worthless. Like, your autos do no damage at all. You bought a pink and Negatron cloak, so this is gimping you. Yeah, you might not get poked down as hard, but look at the damage you do, even with Thunderlords. It's like, it's not great, right? And so, it's more than I thought, but that's still not great. I mean, imagine what you could have been doing if you actually, okay, so you're all letting him here. He has level 6, you don't. And he fucks up hardcore, flashes into tower range. Love it. Love the low elo shit. So, you're probably never going to win that unless he flashes into tower range like he did. The fact that he did was hilarious. Let's check your gold. If I know how to do that. Okay. I don't know how to check his gold. I don't know, that's weird. I know there's gotta be a way to do it. I just don't know what it is. Okay. Anyway, we come back to lane with attack speed. Fine, that's fine. What we want is Blood Razor, the item, because, well, that's gonna be, God, this hunter, okay. So we want to start Hunter's Machete, and then I think a refillable potion would be better. Because then we can make use of Smite onto Nasus. And with Blood Razor, you get his reduced defenses. And then we're going to start with... Rage Blade. Excuse me. Rage Blade, Runons... a frozen mallet if we need it. That's going to be our defense. Health instead of AP. That was a good kill, good follow. That was good awareness of your kill potential as well. But now our goal 100% is to take this tower as soon as possible. So I am not using that shroom here. I'm using my shroom 100% on... looks like you got one in inventory. Yeah, on the wave. And I am just... butt shoving this in into the tower as hard as I fucking possibly can. I want this tower down before Nasus comes back. Does he even have TP? Yeah, it's down still. So he's got to sit there and watch you just rock his tower. Even though you're doing no damage, you've got the attack speed. Yeah, I do that a lot too, actually. I would absolutely kick his ass right there. I would not allow him to do what he's doing right now. He came back to lane. Why are you backing now? You just saw Lee pass that ward down there. You know he's not coming for you. Stay there and hammer that tower. You want that extra gold. Every tower is still standing in the game. You want to get that tower. Let's see what you buy. You buy 3 daggers. Never, ever, ever buy 3 daggers. And Sork shoes, you want some of the pen? I mean, what Are you trying to get out of his E quicker? Like, okay, I guess, but you still don't do any damage. You're like the more defense he builds, you're building attack speed, that's fine. It's just there's no damage. So again, like, it would be nice to be able to smite him and lower his defenses, because that inadvertently will increase his our damage to him. But attack speed purely is not going to be any help to us. I mean, he's positioning so poorly that he's just eating every bit of damage you can, and that's great for us. So just understand that that's not going to help you as you get higher and higher elo. People are going to not just be eating autos like this. Like, look at this. He walks towards you, and he's just trying to get the wave, and he's like he's just like accepted death there for some reason. Like, I knew as soon as he took a step forward, he was just accepting death. So here's a situation. We know Lee's bot. This is good. You're staying. Please don't back. Yes. Good. Perfect. And I don't think Nasus has TP. He might, though. Okay. Fuck it. We lost the First Blood Tower. See, that's the thing. We lost First Blood Tower. When you don't force the tower like that, it opens the door for our team to throw another tower. So it's great that you got the tower and you traded there, but the First Blood 400 gold is a massive shift in our favor. So let's see what you do with your three daggers. I don't know. You're going to have to buy a recurve bow or a stinger or go towards your jungle item if you're going to get one. I don't know. I really hope. Okay, I like to take this flower into the pit. Okay, that's a more aggressive route. Oh, so you just straight. Okay, kite him into the shroom. If you're gonna have a shroom, kite him into the shroom. Okay, that was actually hilarious. We're gonna watch that again. So I would kite him into the shroom. You don't really know the Lee's coming, so I'd kite him into it. I don't know what this Lee is doing. One more time. I just want to see when you're queuing here. Okay, so all he does is kick you. He doesn't queue you at the same time. Alright, so here's the problem. You just queued him there. By the time it seemed like a panic queue to me. So, like, he can't auto attack you right now because he just kicked you away. What's the point in queuing him, right? Your Q does zero damage. You don't have any AP at all. So why would you queue him unless it's for an execute, right? Unless he queued you and he's going to queue to you right now. It doesn't, like, queuing there doesn't matter. By the time he just walks up to you, the queue's gonna wear off and he's just gonna punch you to death. So what you need to do is just auto as soon as he gets on to you. If he walks towards you, like, this distance, you should be kiting away this way into the brush. Because you don't have your queue, you need to get into that brush so that he can't actually, like, see you until he walks over there and wastes a few more seconds until your queue comes back. So you queue him and now you're autoing, and if Vi was not here, you would 100% be dead. But you survive it. It's fine. So you guys decide to take the tower. Okay. Alright, so let's see what you bought. Wit's End, and now you're going towards Hextech. Okay. That's fine. Yeah, I guess. I mean, you got the... Oh, okay. That makes sense. And that is... No. Is that right? Yeah, you bought the you were like in, like I wish I saw the gold amounts because you were instead of the recurve bow you bought three daggers, which actually does make sense. Okay, I stand corrected. I think that the incremental increase from recurve bow instead of three. Oh boy, you're fucked. Oh, you're dead. Wow. That was slightly overkill. Let's go back. Alright, so let's do blue fog only. So at this very moment, we don't know where any of their team is. We see Nasus, we see MF. That's it. Then we see Lee. Okay, we're just getting out of there now. Okay, yeah, there's nothing you can do about this, really. Only real thing you can do is the fact that you don't see anyone on the map and there's no vision whatsoever in this area would give me a little bit of caution. Like, I would have... what level are you? You're level... Well, let's see. Okay. You are... Fuck's sake, I have no idea what level you are. But you should be buying a blue trinket as quickly as possible. What are you doing? Okay, so you should be buying blue trinket as quickly as possible just so you can... Ooh, yeah, max range. She's doing a ton of damage. She's 6-0. You gotta be real careful. This is support Annie, so she's not dealing too much damage yet. So you can actually delete her, but you just gotta be careful of her stun. She can't really do much to us. Again, you're walking into fog. Even though this is your side of the map, you don't have shit warded here, so I want a blue trinket there to cover this entrance. I like your shroom there, and I want a shroom there. That's what's gonna cover your ass against shit that happened to you like that before. You would have seen that Lux coming, you would have seen that Annie coming. And then you are safe to walk that deep into the jungle. Even though you don't have your tower down here, you've lost two mid towers, which does open this up to no man's land, meaning you don't have control of this area of the jungle. Even with these two towers up, that's why its mid towers are so powerful and important. Even though all of your towers are standing, this area is still danger to you, unless you've got it warded. So avoid it at all costs. I don't know what you're doing necessarily, like going for these kills, like a pick on Nasus, great. You know, like fine. What are you gonna turn that into? Rift Herald, right? Like, where are you going now? You've taken their top laner out, why don't you go hit this tower a bunch, force their team up top lane, which is what you're doing, which is great, and then start pinging, ping, 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 ping. Okay, tell Azir and Ashe. Ashe right now is going to join the gangbang. Why? You've done what your job was, right? I'm going to slow this down so I can talk. You've done your job of killing the Nasus top lane. Your next job was to start shoving this wave out so that they were forced to deal with the wave over here and send resources, meaning more than one person to deal with Teemo and whoever else is with him. Which what that allows to do is the rest of the map to completely open up, right? If there's dragon, free dragon, right? But since there isn't, you've got two free towers up here, you can't be attacking them, so you need to tell your team to do that, right? So Ashe was like last hitting, fucking dicking around because she's behind, and way behind. And she thought, oh, I just want farm. No, you need to tell your team what to do, right? You can't assume that they're gonna know, oh, the team's leaving mid, I can take this tower. No, they're thinking, oh, team's leaving mid. I get to free farm for longer because I'm the AD carry and that's what I should be doing. No, fuck that guy. Spam ping that tower until they feel bad about not doing it, right? So that's your job. No one was in bot, so there's no point in spamming that. Now they've been able to rotate back. Your minion wave is, let's see where it's pushing. Yeah, we're like slightly pushing to them, like minimally. Instead of, you know, them having to actually send someone to do it, and Nasus is back, so it doesn't even matter. He's building a spirit. He's building defense. He's not even building a ZZ Rot yet. If he had a ZZ Rot, you would be in a lot of trouble. This Lux is hitting everything. That's unfortunate. You got to be very careful of that. You're going to have to flank the shit out of her, wait until she burns some shit, and then flank her. Going stealth middle of the lane would be something that I would do. This is fine that you're going to go split bottom, but blue trinket. I mean, you're 17 minutes into the game. You're level 12. I'm blind as a bat. You should never get past level 9 without actually buying a blue trinket. Because if the blue trinket, you can ward here. You can just ward right in the middle here. You can just ward the edge of that brush. I would not leave. I would stand stealth right here. And I would wait till MF. Because Annie's not going to butt-buddy her. Or she shouldn't. It's a total waste. I would be standing stealth right here. Waiting for her to clear out this wave. And as soon as she did, I would surprise... beat the shit out of her. You can see how much damage she gets taken. But you decide to go back mid. Your job with Smite Teemo is to split push. You're not team fighting for shit. Your team fight is actually massively worse as Smite Teemo. So grouping with your team is now no longer allowed whatsoever. And you have to assume everything is warded. So you gotta start... I would even, instead of blue trinket, one person on both teams has upgraded their trinket. I love this elo. It's horrible. Oh, boy. She really flashed. Okay. You've got some regen, so I would take Rift Scuttle, because if anything else, it brings you to full health and you get division. And then it allows you to take this bot tower. Right now, you've just looped all the way around this way. It just seems like you don't really know where you're going or why you're going there. Like, right now, you're just standing in case shit happens. Okay, you're greeting for this Lux kill. No reason to do that. Why would you walk back into it? You walked out of it, and then you walked back into it. I think this is something that you know. I just don't think you were looking at the fact that you were getting ulted. I'm going to go back even further than that. Okay, so again, slow it way down. So they're trying to get the Rift Scuttler so that they can... The River Scuttle so that they can take this Cloud Drake. It's fucking Cloud. Who cares? Let them have it. What you need to be doing is taking this big-ass wave and the next one and this tower and this tower and this tower... Nasus is top. He cannot clear towers as fast as you can. Maybe with your kind of shit item build. I mean, with Smite, this item build isn't ideal. I mean, yeah, it's fine. You're basically ignoring the fact that you have Smite. It's just basically another potential Dragon or Baron steel tool. It's not going to be a tool to help you in-game. And I actually haven't been talking too much, which is why I'm going to have to redo that. Okay, let's go slow. Can I go slow in 2 foot? No, okay. So, my point is, you need to take this wave here. It's a big wave. Take the next wave, next one a tower, and then take the tower. It's going to make them choose between dragon and defending top tower. Most likely, they're going to take dragon instead because it's their tier, you know, 3 tower. They don't give a fuck about that tower. Or they're dumb and they're like, fuck the dragon. We want to keep that tower, right? So, you got to force them into that decision, and then all the while, well, they have to decide that. They have to decide, okay, do we have to... Well, we're getting poked by his ear. We're getting... So this is a terrible arrow that actually got you killed, I think, because everyone was so far away that there was nothing that could be done about it. Here comes your flash. Okay. We're going to go back again. Okay, if you want the awareness, okay, so if you had the awareness, you would have flashed, like, that was the latest flash of all time, right? Not to mention you had Annie in, okay, so you walked out of the redemption, so you were safe here, and then you kind of walked back into it. I'm not quite sure what you were looking at. But okay, here we go. Full speed. You should have flashed so much earlier than that. Like, right now you're flashing, but you got to understand, you had vision. Like, this was tunnel. This was pure tunnel. Like, I'm not sure what you were looking at to get you killed there, because there was no one low in your vision. So, again, that was just kind of a silly death, which is fine. You've only had two deaths. Both of them were silly. Not silly. The first one wasn't silly. The first one was just unlucky. But I shouldn't say that. First one was avoidable because you shouldn't have been that far up into a jungle where you had no vision. But the fact that you got caught and killed is, you know, it sucks. But just understand that that's why you died the first time. Second time was just a silly death. That should not have happened. You should be 4-1 right now. But you got your Hex Tech. You got Wet Send. You've got your boots. You actually do some decent damage now. So I think you're probably paying the Ashe, which you shouldn't. She needs the farm. She's fucking worthless. She only has a BF sword. You're not carrying, even though you do have 4 kills. You are not the one carrying this game, because right now, okay, I would not be taking this if I were you. This is just a waste of time. Yeah, great, you're using your smite on it to do it faster, but you need to draw the team up to you. Right now they don't give a fuck, because we lost mid. Their wave clear is kind of garbage compared to ours with Ashe, I think. Yeah, maybe. I would just... No. You're backing now. You need to continue this push. Continue this push and force them to make a decision. Right now, you're joining up with your team to do what? Right? You're not going to get there before the team fight ends, right? Like, they disengaged. You just get here, and now what? Right? Like, that was a total waste of time. Ashe is going up mid. You've got no vision here, so they could all be in that brush there and just delete you. So that was dangerous, just approaching that brush. They could have sweeped it and all stood in there and then just deleted you with Annie ult. Or an Annie stun. Now you're what? Standing stealth here? I mean, you don't really do much burst damage. I mean, you do a little bit, sure, but... you bought a Wit's End instead of a Nashor's Tooth, and you're going attack speed instead of AP. So your utility and surprise attacking people is kind of worthless. The surprise, the stealth in middle of the lane is only for full AP Teemo. You're going attack speed hybrid Teemo, in which you get like a burst of half damage, but your job is to kite. Okay, you're going to be doing as much damage as you can while kiting. Like, this Nasus has got a lot of defense, not a lot of attack. So, again, nobody. You're kiting. Did you flash there? Who the fuck flashed? Was that the Lee who flashed? Ah, yeah, you didn't flash. Okay, let's watch this. Let's go back. Okay, so half speed. So you throw... Okay, so... I would already be walking this way. You were... Alright, so you were fucking exhausted by that Nasus shit. And you had your Q up. Okay, and then Ash just flashed. Okay, fine. I mean, you were pretty fucked there anyway. But you could have dodged that Lee Q when he hopped to his ward and then Q'd you. As soon as you see him like coming around, you stop hugging the wall. You need to start creating distance from yourself. Here, let me just... Okay, so I'm going to go back one more. Okay, so I'm going to show you what I mean. As soon as you see the Lee coming and he exhausts you there, put that down. But you need to start creating more distance by going out this way. You walk out this way. It's a lot harder of a cue for him to hit than walking down this way, because you're hugging the wall. It shows him exactly where you're going. It's almost impossible to miss that, right? So you need to start walking this way, okay, away from the wall, because almost every time he's going to assume that you're going to go down that wall. If you don't get hit by that, you could actually probably still make it by dropping more shrooms down to your tower. But you don't, no big deal. Your team's getting fucked. You come back. I mean, this game is rough. I mean, you got Lux is just super. I mean, your team doesn't know what the fuck they're doing. They'd rather save top than mid. Fine. I mean, okay, yeah, you're officially doing no damage to the guy. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you're pretty much, you're done. I mean, this game's over. I think that I should probably pretty much end it here. I think you probably surrendered, didn't you? All they have to do is go back, take Baron, and you guys lose. But this is, I think, Bronze Elo, so I'm not quite sure. Yeah, I mean, I think, again, the mistakes that we made in this game, even though our scoreboard doesn't reflect it, all of the deaths were avoidable. First one was just a lack of awareness. Second one was a complete and total lack of awareness. Third one was unfortunate. We could have made some small tweaks to save ourselves. And the fourth one there, we just got caught by another binding. We're trying to stall the game out, but again, there's not a lot we can do. They're going to focus everything on bot now. You just have to stall the game out in this situation and try and create time for your inhibitors to come back if you really thought it was possible to win. Otherwise, I would just... I mean, look how far behind your Ashe is. She still hasn't bought an Infinity Edge. I mean, this is 25 minutes into the game. She has no Infinity Edge. Meanwhile, MF has IE and a fucking Reaver and a Black Cleaver. Like, this is... This is really rough. And your mid lane is 1-9. I don't know why anyone plays Azir. And then the Lux is 9-1. This is pretty much a done game. I mean, you by yourself could bring it back by, like... I would stop building attack speed and just go start building straight damage so that you could trade Lux for yourself every time and just suicide for her every time, because then their other damage dealer is MF, which your team can definitely focus. And once those two are down, there's not much else they can do, and then you can maybe start turning some team fights and let Vi do some damage. But your goal is to get that Lux the fuck out of there. So always look for her on the map somewhere and then position yourself so that you can potentially get that kill. Let's see what you do here. You're... Okay. You're pushing top lane. Let me just see what happened there. Okay, so your Azir just decides YOLO. Decides melee range Azir is the way to do it. That was close. Let's see what we could have done. Okay, here I would be queuing zero times. Let's see where your queue goes right now. Okay, actually that was a fine queue. Oh dear, that was so close. Alright. Ooh, how does he dodge that? I don't understand. This Vi's probably gonna die to him too. Yeah. Yeah, he has probably got some stacks. I mean, look how much CS he has. Just seems like all he's been doing is stacking all game. When your Nasus has 250, you're in a lot of trouble. Yeah, there's not much you could do there. Before we let the game end, I'm going to go over that last fight one more time because there was something you could do here. All right, so I know you think you have him killed here. I know you think you have him killed here, which is why, like, you see your health and his health, and you think, oh, okay, Nasus has 456 and Teemo has, hold on, let's see if I can, yeah. Teemo has 625, right? So we have, it looks like we have way more than he does. We don't. It's like very slightly more. So we blind that Q. We get him down. We lose like 100 health maybe. He's down to 241, right? Problem is his Q's on a short cooldown, so we can't just stand in the middle of his E and all of his shit. Okay, so we get autoed there, so we know the Q's off. So next Q is going to kill him. Kill us, yeah. So the problem we have here, just standing in that spot, is that, like, we're standing in one spot. This is why you never stand in one spot, ever, even if you're trying to DPS hard. At least just walk out of his E. You're taking damage this whole time. Or walk straight left so you won't get blocked by the tower grave. But you've literally not clicked anything away. Like, you need to attack move here. This is attack move time. He's going to be focused on the Azir, which means you need to, like, you're standing, like, you're Teemo in melee range against a Nasus. Why are you standing so still right now? You should be kiting backwards so that he has to walk forward to auto you. You can't just assume or just be like, all right, fuck it. Either he's going to kill me or I'm going to kill him here, because that is a really dangerous game. You can see why this is the reason. You are going to lose that every time. Not every time, but this is why rolling the dice like that is a problem. And if you kited back 100%, you would not have died there and you would have gotten the kill unless he ran away. And he might have run away, which is fine, but he would not have been in range. He shouldn't have been in range to cue you there at all. So the fact that he was able to do that is unfortunate. And again, that was definitely something you can prevent. So yeah, unfortunate game. Your team was fucking worthless completely. But you definitely made a lot of mistakes that you can also improve on. And the fact that your macro decision making was pretty bad as well. You should not be grouping with your team whatsoever. Your job as Teemo is to literally only split push. Draw their team to you so that you're against a 1-on-2 or a 1-on-3. And then spam ping everything else. So that your team will take it. So that is my suggestion for you. And I hope it helped. Go ahead and just message me on the client or on Skype if you have any more questions. All right, man.